Hi everybody, it's Lance Keltner coming to you from Austin, Texas, and today we're looking at the brand new retro channel gear. Over here we have the retro channel Bob Gjika designed tube amp. Now when I say tube amp, yeah, you say that looks like a preamp. Yeah, it kind of does, except for the fact that in this box there are two 12AX7s, an EL84, power transformers and everything, and a little tiny little special speaker in there that acts as a reactive load. So basically you're running power amp distortion, preamp distortion and all through your effects, which we're using today, an Axe effects for just a reverb and delay, down to our stereo solid state retro channel power amp. Now, we just decided to double the wattage on the power amp. So at 4 ohms, you're gonna be able to pull about 150 watts with the stereo amp. Now, to a formidable rig together, it sounds tremendous through cabinets. I've been using it through a pair of 212s and I really love it. Let's go back to the Gjika designed retro channel amp here for a moment. Basically from left to right, ta-da, you got sustain switch. Now what the sustain switch generally is used for is it cuts the power back but increases the gain, so you can use this in front of like a non-master volume amp as a gain device like a Marshall. Imagine this being like the coolest gain pedal on earth. Now it will be an expensive gain pedal, but a cool gain pedal nonetheless. Under that, you got the boost function. Boost function, it basically adds more front-end gain, so you can get a, kind of a really cool dead clean sound out of this, or all the way up to what I was just doing. Obviously, you have your volume, treble, mid-range, and bass, and a master volume. Now, the cool thing about the master volume, you think, why do we need a master volume on a preamp, really? Well, really the reason is because the higher you run the master volume, the more power amp tube saturation you get. So when you crank this thing all the way up on the master, it really gets that super sort of Eric Johnson like compression like you get out of a giant cranked tube amp. As you back it off, you get a little bit less of that, so you can really kind of fine tune your sound. Now looking at the retro channel power amp, the great thing about this power amp, we're going to show it to you with a few different things today, is it's fantastic with our amp. It's also amazing with any other preamp on the market, as well as all the great modelers that are out there right now, like the Axe Effects, the Digi 11, the Kemper. Any of those kinds of things will work really well with our power amp. Now, what sets our power amp apart from the other power amps on the market is we use our proprietary technology in here, so it actually feels, sounds, and responds like a real tube amp. And each channel has a volume control as well as a master. The reason we do that is because if you're using a modeling device that's not a tube thing, like this is tube, using something that's not tube and you want to get a little bit more cushion, a little bit more push, and a little bit more compression, you can drive the front end of the power amp a little harder and actually get more of that. You can turn this down and get less of it if you want as well, more of a real sort of flat response amp. Now, it's got, each of the channels has a master volume as well. It has a resonance control, which actually helps to balance the power amp with a particular cabinet. So you can really fine tune it to the cabinet of your choice, whether it's an open back, closed back. You can add a little bit more dimension, a little less, based on what you need there. And then also, it's got a presence control. I like to run it up a little hot because to me it kind of sounds like the presence control on a 60s Marshall. It gives you a little bit more Kerrang. I like that word, Kerrang, on the top end. So if you listen to this, responds like a real tube amp. I'm using the volume to clean up a little bit. And then you can do this. And the wonderful thing about this is that you can do this at levels below the level I'm talking. And because our amp that we use has all the power tube distortion already there, you can use our power amp as kind of a whole master volume network. So you're basically monitoring levels. You're controlling your monitoring levels. So you can get a sound at the level I'm talking, all the way up to using 4 4x12s per side. You could use 8 4x12s with this and just really peel paint off the wall. So stick around with us. We want to show you some more applications for the power amp. But call me, get in touch with us about the Gjika Design tube amp that we're offering. The price is to be announced here in the next couple of days. You can reach us at www.retro-channel.com, or you can call me at 877-983-8988. I'll pick up the phone. I'll talk you through it. You do want this. It is very groovy. So hang with us just a minute. We'll look at some other things. I'm Lance. Thanks. Bye-bye.